नमस्ते खुशराव भुटिया, आई एम JVN डॉक्टर सुनील तभाटी एंड आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू एडवांस जावा प्रोग्रामिंग. ओके, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई एम टेकिंग इंट्रोडक्टरी पार्ट. जावा जावा इज डिवाइडेड इनटू टू पार्ट्स. फर्स्ट इज कोर जावा एंड द नेक्स्ट इज एडवांस जावा. द कोर जावा पार्ट कवर्स द फंडामेंटल कंसेप्ट्स लाइक डेटा टाइप्स, फंक्शंस, ऑपरेटर्स, रूट, थ्रेड, एक्सेप्शन हैंडलिंग एटसेट्रा ऑफ द जावा प्रोग्रामिंग लैंग्वेज. It is used to develop general purpose applications, whereas advanced Java covers the standard concepts such as database connectivity, networking, servlet, web services, address, etc. Advanced Java is a part of Java programming language. It is an advanced technology or advanced version of Java, specially designed to develop web-based, network-centric, or enterprise applications. It includes the concepts like servlet, JSP, JDBC, RMI, socket programming, etc. It is a specialization in specific domain. Most of the applications developed using advanced Java uses two-tier architecture, that is client and server. All the applications that runs on server can be considered as advanced Java applications. Benefits of advanced Java. There are so many benefits of advanced Java. I am going to discuss here. You can see on the screen. First of all, JEE, Java Enterprise Edition, provides libraries to understand the concept of client-server architecture for web-based application. By using JEE, you can create web-based applications or enterprise applications, and client-server architecture follows in your application. Next is, we can also work with web and application servers such as Apache, Tomcat, and Glassfish. Using these servers, we can understand the working of HTTP protocol. It cannot be done in core Java. It is also important to understand advanced Java if you are dealing with traditional technologies like Hadoop, cloud native, and data science. It provides a set of services, API. API means application programming interface. API and protocols that provides the functionality which is necessary for developing multi-tiered application, web-based application. There is a number of advanced Java frameworks like Spring, Hibernate, Strut that enables us to develop secure transaction-based web applications such as banking application, inventory management application, etc. Now, difference between core Java and advanced Java. On the basis of the following criteria, first of all, used for core Java. It is used to develop general purpose application. Core Java is used to develop general purpose application. And advanced Java is used to develop web-based application. What is the purpose? If we want to differentiate core Java and advanced Java on the basis of purpose, then core Java does not deal with database, socket programming, etc. But advanced Java, it deals with the socket programming, networking application, etc. On the basis of architecture, core Java is a single-tier architecture and advanced Java is a multi-tier architecture. On the basis of edition, core Java is Java standard edition. It's a standard edition. And advanced Java, it is a Java Enterprise Edition. On the basis of package, it provides java.lang.asterisk package. And in advanced Java, it provides java.servlet.asterisk package. Means, if you want to, using core Java programming, if you want to do programming in core Java, then you have to include java.lang.asterisk package and if you are making program in advanced Java, then you have to use java.servlet.asterisk package. Now Java AWT, what is AWT? Abstract Window Toolkit. The full form of AWT is Abstract Window Toolkit. So Java AWT, what is the meaning of Java AWT? Java AWT Abstract Window Toolkit is an API to develop GUI or window based applications in Java. Means if you want to create GUI application or window-based applications in Java, then you have to use Java AWT API. API means application programming interface. API is collection of so many classes and packages. Java AWT components are platform dependent. That is, components are displayed according to the view of operating system. AWT is heavyweight. That is, its components are using the resources of OS, operating system. The Java.AWT package provides classes for AWT API, such as text field, label, text area, radio button, checkbox, choice, list, etc. These are all the classes, AWT class. Java AWT hierarchy. The hierarchy of Java AWT classes is shown in the figure. There are so many classes: button, label, checkbox, choice, list, container. Container. In container, we have frame, dialog, window, applet, panels. And if we want to do programming, AWT, we want to use these classes, button, label. So we have to create objects of these classes. So what is a container? The container is a component in AWT that can contain another components like buttons, text fields, labels, etc. The classes that extends container class are known as container, such as frame, dialog, and panel. Frame, dialog, and panel is also a container. And container, what container will do? Container holds or contains the other components like buttons, text fields, labels, etc. Now, the next term is window. The window is the container that have no borders and menu bars. You must use frame, dialog, or another window for creating a window. If you want to create a window, you have to use frame, dialog, and another window. Okay. Now, the next is panel. The panel is the container. Panel is also a container that doesn't contain title bar and menu bars. It can have other components like button, text fields, etc. Means panel can contain buttons, text fields, labels, etc. But it does not contain menu bar and title. Now the next is frame. The frame is the container that contain title bar and can have menu bars. Means frame contains both these bars, title bars and menu bars. It can have other components like button, text fields, etc. Means frame is a container that contains title bar, menu bar, buttons, text fields, other components also. Useful methods of component class. What are the methods you can use in your program to add any component? First of all, public void add method. Add method, there is one argument you have to pass in add method, that is component object. You have to pass a component object into add method. To add any component like button or label or text field, etc. What is its description? It inserts a component on this component. public void set size. Set size is a method having two arguments, integer width and integer height. Means set size, this method sets the size of the component. Component means button, it may be button, it may be label, it may be text field, etc. You have to set the size of these components by using set size method. And there are two arguments, width and height. Now the next method is set layout method. This method defines the layout manager of the for the component. Now the next is public function set visible. Set visible having an argument like boolean status. It means it changes the visibility of the component. Set visible true or false means if you want to show any component, then you have to set visible true. And if you doesn't want to show the component on the window, then set visible passes the argument false. These four methods are of public type. These all methods are public. Okay. Now Java AWT example. Java AWT example. To create simple AWT example, we need a frame. There are two ways to create a frame in AWT. First method is by extending frame class by using inheritance concept. And the next is by creating the object of frame class. This is association concept. Now, we will describe both the method. First of all, we are taking AWT example by inheritance. So let's see the example. Import java.awt.sts. First of all, we are importing java.awt.sts package, advanced abstract window toolkit package. We are going to import AWT package. So we may able to use abstract window toolkit classes, AWT classes in our program. So let's start the coding. First of all, we create a class. First we write class, and the next is class name first, and then extends is a keyword which is used to inherit any class. So extends frame is AWT component, AWT class, so frame class. We are inheriting frame class into first class. So frame class is AWT class, and we are inheriting this frame class in our program. Now we will start class body using opening braces. Now the next step is we are making a class constructor, its name, a method, its name first. Class name and its method name is same first, and parenthesis pair is having null arguments. And we will start the body of the function, opening braces, and first statement is button b equals to new button and passing argument string argument click me, and then semicolon. It means we are creating a button object. Its name is b and its label is click me. Here in this line, button 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 is the class, AWT class, and b is its object. Means we are creating a b object of button class, and we are defining its label is click me. The next step is b.set bounds, and passing our, we are going to pass arguments 30, 100, 80, 30 and sample. Means set bounds is a method which is used to set button position on the window or frame. B is the object of button object, B is the button object, and set bound is the method which is used to set button position from where we have to create, from which position we have to create the button and what its size will be. So both the things, we are passing four arguments in set bounds method. First is x-axis value, y-axis value, width and height of the button. Now, after setting button position, the next statement is add method. And we are passing B object, button object, into add method. Add, this add method adds this button B into frame. Now, the next method is set size. Now, we are going to set the size of the frame, 300 by 300. Width is 300 and height is also 300. Means frame size will be 300 by 300. This is in pixel. Now, the next is set layout method. We are passing the argument null into set layout because we are not using any layout manager. And the next step is set visible method. We are calling set visible method and passing argument true. Means we are making the frame visible on the screen. So we are passing the argument true. And now closing braces of the class. Now this is the complete formation or definition of the class first. And after that, we will make main function, main method, public static void main, and passing argument string args, which is of array type string array. And now starting the body of the main function, we are going to start the body of main function and making the first class object f. So first is the class name and f is the object name. This equals to new first at opening and closing opening and closing parenthesis pair and semicolon. This statement tells us that we are creating an object f which is of first class. Means f is a object of first class. So now the next is we are closing the body of main method, and then we are closing the body of class, first class. Above we have closed the body of first method, that is also a constructor of first class. And the last closing braces closes the class body. This is starting here and ending here. So this is the program of a frame class, and we are creating here a frame and a button on that frame. And what will be the output? It will show the window like this. This is a frame, and this is the frame, and click me is the label, and this is a button. Okay, so this is all about the frame class. We created a frame in this program by using inheritance concept. Now the next is, we can create a frame by association concept also. What is the association concept? We will see in this program. Import java.awt.*. We will import the AWT package. Now we create the class first two. Its name is first two. And start the body of the class, opening braces. Now we again constructing a constructor first2. First2 is a constructor because its name and class name is same and having null argument. There is no argument in the function. Now we are starting the body of the function and creating a object f, and f is the object of frame class. So if we want to create any object of a class, we have to write class name, frame. This is AWT class frame, single space, object name f. This is equals to new keyword, is a keyword which creates object in memory, and single space frame, again class name frame, and parenthesis pair semicolon. Here new keyword, constructing an object f of frame class. Now the next statement is, you can understand, you know that what is going to be performed here. Here B object is creating and its class is button. It means button object B is creating here and its label is click me. Now we are calling set bounds method of button B object, B is object dot, it is calling set bounds method to set the button position on the frame. So x axis position is 30, y axis position is 50, and width 80, and height is 30. These are all in pixel. Now f frame object is calling a method add, f dot add, and passing argument object b is a button. Means we are going to add button b into frame f. Here we are adding our button into frame f. Now set the size. We are setting the size of frame f as 300 by 300, means width is 300 and height is 300. Frame size is 300 by 3. Now the next is f dot set layout, and passing argument null because no layout manager is used here. So we are setting the value null in set layout. Now f dot set visible true, means frame f is visible on the screen. If we are passing the argument true, it shows on the screen, and if we passes the argument false, then it does not show on the screen. So if we want to show it on the screen, we have to call set visible method, and we have to pass true as a argument. The syntax is f dot set visible true. We have to write f dot set visible true so that our frame is visible on the screen. Okay. Now we write closing braces. This is the closing of first two method, constructor method. Now again we have to create main method in our program, because execution of the program starts with the main. So it is very essential to make a main method, public static void main, string args. We have to pass string args as argument. Now we are creating in main method body f object. This is of first to class. The syntax is first to class name first to. Now object name f equals to new is a keyword which creates f object in the main memory of class type first to. First to and parenthesis pair and semicolon. Here, because at first two, we have created a constructor first two. So an object created in the memory F, as we create an object F in the memory, the constructor automatically calls first two constructor method automatically call and perform these steps and gives the following output as shown in the on the screen. The output is like this: a frame or window appears on the screen having a button and its label is click me. So this is all about the simple frame program. I'm ending my session here with this topic. Now we will discuss other topics later on in our next class. Thank you.